Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta and this is our second lecture on class 11th complex number. The chapter number is 5 for both the mathematics, NCERT as well as element mathematics. Now we are going to take exercise 5.2 from the element mathematics, and this is your first exercise 5.1 if you are reading from your NCERT. NCERT combines all the concepts almost in one exercise, but in element mathematics we will found in different exercise like 5.1, 5.2, 5.3. So I request everyone, please, if you are reading from the NCERT, then you also do element mathematics for your practice, because NCERT contains almost each and every type of question, but the questions are very less, not for your practice purpose. So element mathematics has different questions so that you can do practice more, because practice makes a man perfect. So before to start the video, I request everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to end. And I request those students who still not watch my previous video, so please to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes and press the button like and go to my playlist, then you will found there is a first lecture on complex number. Now this is our second lecture, so please come on our first topic. Before to start the exercise 5.2, we have to discuss some properties of the complex number, because the whole exercise is based on the properties that we are dealing here. First property is, if a plus iota b, what is a plus iota b? A and b are both the real numbers, but when the real number is connect with iota, it becomes an imaginary number. So that's why a is your real number and b is imaginary number. When we separate them on talks, a is called your real number and iota b is called an imaginary number. So if we combine them, real number plus imaginary number, we got a number which is called a complex number. So that's why I am writing here, a plus iota b is a complex number. And the first property we state, if the complex number is equal to 0, it means the real part is equal to 0 as well as the imaginary part is equal to 0. Again repeat the concept, if a complex number is equal to, it means real part is equal to 0 and imaginary part is also equal to 0. It means a is equal to 0 and b is equal to 0. This is your first property. Second property is, read the statement, if a plus iota b is equal to c plus iota d. A plus iota b is nothing, it which is your first complex number. You can write in any representation, for example x plus iota y can be write, or you can also write as x1 plus my iota y1. It's your wish as you want to represent it. I am here representing our first complex number as a plus iota b, and second complex number is represented as a c plus iota d. It shows if the two complex number are equal, then we use the equating property of the complex number. What it state? It state that if two complex numbers are equal, then real parts is equal to real parts and imaginary part is equal to imaginary parts. This is the equality property of a complex number. Again I repeat, the real part is equal to real part and imaginary part is equal to imaginary part. Whenever you find equal in the complex number expression, then you can equate in there. Third property is, sum or difference of two complex number quantity is also a complex quantity. It means if you add or you subtract, take difference of two complex number, then you will get another quantity, and that quantity is also a complex quantity. It means if you add two complex number, you will get another complex number. If you subtract two complex number, then you will get another complex number. Similarly, the fourth property is product. It means if you multiply two complex number, then the resultant quantity is also a complex quantity. Fifth property is the quotient. Quotient means you have to divide. If you divide two complex number, then you also get a complex number. These are the five properties of the complex number. Now I am going to take one by one property for the complex number. first property is based on addition of the complex number. Then how many properties of complex number in terms of its additions? So first property is commutative. Commutative means if you are going to add two complex number z1 plus means z2, then the same result you will be got if you add z2 plus z1. It means if you add 2 plus 3 which is equal to 5, and if you change the order 3 plus 2 which is also 5. This is basically for the number case, but we are going here for the complex number. If you take two complex number z1 and z2 and add them z1 plus z2, the same result you will be got if you replace z2 plus z1. It means z1 plus z2 is equal to z2 plus z1. This is your property of commutative. So additions also follow the commutative property, as well as multiplications property also follow the same property, commutative. It means if you multiply z1 into z2, the same result you will get z2 multiply z1. This is commutative property for the multiplication, and this one is the commutative property for the addition. Second property is associative. Associative means if you do associate additions with further additions or multiplication with further multiplication. It means if you have three complex number and if you want to add them, then the procedure that you will be followed, either you can add first z1 plus z2, then the result will add to the third complex number. You will get the same result if you add first z2 plus z2 three complex number, and then the result will add to the z1. The same result will be obtained. Same multiplication is also associative. It means if you multiply z1 into z2 into z3. So if you multiply z1 into z2, then you get a complex number, and that result complex number is multiplied with the third complex number, with the same result. If you multiply first z2 and z3 multiply, then you get another complex number, and that complex number is multiplied with the first complex number, is called the associative property. I hope you understand this concept. I am writing here z1 plus z2 is equal to z2 plus z1, or in the case you can write as z1 into z2 which is equal to z2 into z1. Associative z1 plus z2 into z3, this first we are adding z2 plus z3, then the result is added with z1. But in this case we are adding z1 plus z2, and then we got another complex number which is added to the z3. The same results you will be obtained. This is the commutative and associative property for the additions as well as for the multiplications. Now third one property is additive identity. Additive identity means if you add some complex number in any complex number and you get the same complex number, is called the additive identity. I am again repeat the statement, but I say if I add a complex number with a complex number and it gives the same result, which is called identity property. If I take a complex number which is zero complex number, it means real part is also zero and imaginary part is also zero. For example, this a plus iota b, I am taking real part is zero and as well imaginary part is zero. So if you add them, for example, please make a look here. If z is equal to a plus iota b, this is your complex number, and I am adding zero complex number means 0 plus 0 iota. If I add them, 0 that plus 0, what will get? A plus 0 will A and B plus 0 B. We get the same complex number which is equal to A plus iota B. It means if we add a complex number with a 0 complex number, the result will be same. So 0 is the identity element for the additions. The same here is multiplicative identity. It means if you multiply a complex number with any complex number and get the same result, it means if we have a complex number z and it multiply with another complex number, but the result is also a z, which is called the multiplicative identity. then what's the multiplications which is equal to 1. 1 means it's not a real part. I am talking about a complex number. So 1 is a complex number. How can be written as 1 plus 0 iota? It means real part is 1, but the imaginary part is null. It means imaginary part is 0. So I am taking as a 1 is equal to 1 plus 0 iota. If we multiply this complex number, one complex number with z, we get the same z. Or if we multiply 1 to the z, we get the same equal to z. So 1 is your complex number and this is your multiplicative identity. I hope you are understanding this. For the additive case, what is the additive identity is 0, and what is the in the multiplicative identity is 1, and 0 is a complex number and as well as 1 is also a complex number. Now fifth property, or you can say that according to this numbering, fourth property is additive inverse. Additive inverse is what you already know. If we add 2 plus minus 2, we get result 0, which is called additive inverse. For example, if I am taking 2, what is the additive inverse of 2 is? Minus 2. Because if we add them, we get a result 0. So this property is called additive inverse. Same here, if our complex number is z and I add z plus negative of z, we get a 0. So z, what is the additive inverse of z is negative z. If we add them, z plus minus z, we get a 0 complex number. So what's the additive inverse of a complex number is minus z. Same here, multiplicative inverse. What's the multiplicative inverse is what? It's 4 3. What's the multiplicative inverse is 1 by 3. Because if we multiply them, we get 1. So this is the rule of the multiplicative inverse. This property you already studied in class 8. So I am taking just an overview. So in this case, what's the multiplicative of complex number? Z is Z inverse. Z inverse basically indicates that Z into Z inverse. If we solve them, Z into 1 upon Z, we get 1. So what's the multiplicative inverse of Z is Z inverse. So multiplicative inverse of Z is Z inverse. I hope these all properties will be clear to you. Please all these properties keep it in mind. Then we are start our first question. Please make a note first. So this is your first question, exercise 5.2. You have to do evaluate. It has three parts: first part, second part, and third part. So try to do solve simultaneously with myself. For example, this is minus 4 square. You know, minus is replaced by iota square. So we can write it as 4 iota square. If you are those students who still not watch my video, please make a look first. Minus 4 can be represented as 4 into minus 1 multiply same here 1 minus 64 can be written as 64 into minus 1. And you know what iota square is equal to minus 1. We have to use this property. Now it becomes 4 into iota square multiply 1 minus 64 iota square. And this can be written as 4 iota square can be written as 2 iota whole square. 2 iota whole square multiply 1 minus, it can also be written as 8 iota whole square. And whole square will be cancelled out with square root. So we get 2 iota multiply 1 minus 8 iota. Now solve this. Firstly, 2 iota into 1, we get 2 iota negative 2 iota into 8 iota. Iota into iota, iota square. And 2 into 18, 16, which is equal to 2 iota minus 16. And what is iota square value is minus 1. So we get 2 iota plus 16. This is your final answer. Now solve this. 1 plus iota whole power 4. Please, first you have to solve this. And I already explained the shortcut method. What's the method? 1 upon mean iota can be written as minus iota. Important. I already explained such a concept. If you not read, please do a long cut method by taking iota as a common. So 1 plus 1 by iota. If I do rationalize iota into iota, this term is multiplied by iota into iota. And what's the result? 1 plus iota whole power 4, 1 plus 1 into iota, iota, and iota into iota, iota square. Whole power will be 4 as it is. Now solve this. 1 plus iota whole power 4, 1 plus iota divided by iota square is again minus 1. So if we solve this, what's the result? 1 plus iota whole power 4, 1. This is plus and this is minus. It becomes negative. Minus iota whole power 4. Now this term has a power of 4, this term also has a power of 4. So we can do combine and take a single power of 4. So I can write as 1 plus iota into 1 minus iota whole power is equal to 5. Now solve this. You see, basically a plus b, a minus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. I am applying this concept. A is 1 and b is iota. So 1 square minus iota square. And the whole power 4 remains as it is. Now what's the values? 1 square is 1. And what's the values of iota square is minus 1. And again is minus. So I minus minus becomes positive 1. 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 raised to the power 4, which is equal to 6. This is one your final answer. Please make a note first. Now please make a look. Third part of the question 1. We have to do the same step. Now do multiplications. Minus iota into iota, iota square. And minus 1 into 2, minus 2 iota square. Now solve this. Minus 1 iota. Minus 1 into iota, it means minus iota divided by 8 on 2, 3. And we solve this, please. Minus 2. What's the value of iota square is? Minus 1. Now, if we do cube of negative 1, it means negative, negative, negative becomes negative. We get negative. And iota cube is again iota cube and 8 cube. I take the power for each term separate. Now solve this. Minus minus becomes positive 2, negative. And what's the value of iota cube? You already know. What's the value of iota cube is? Minus iota. Or if you don't know, you can write as iota square into iota. And what's the cube of 8? Is 5 and 2. 2 negative. What's the value of iota square is minus 1 into iota as it is divided by 5, 1, 2. Now solve this. 2 1s are 2. If we cut then 256. Negative negative becomes positive. It means we get iota divided by 256, or you can write it as 1 by 256 iota. You can write in terms of this, and you can also write in terms of this representations. Now our second question is express the complex number in terms of a plus iota b. A plus iota b is nothing, it is basically to represent the real part plus the imaginary part 4. So it means we have to solve them and get all the real parts to combine and combine the imaginary parts. That form is called a plus iota b. And in this, what we have? Whole square. And if you got a complex number in terms of whole square, so you can apply the same identity. So I am applying a plus b whole square. What is a square plus b square plus 2 into a into बी। नाउ 2 स्क्वायर 4 आयोटा स्क्वायर प्लस 5 स्क्वायर 25 प्लस 2 × 2 = 4 × 5 20 आयोटा। नाउ व्हाट्स द वैल्यू ऑफ आयोटा स्क्वायर इज -1 प्लस 25 प्लस में 20 आयोटा। दिस इज इक्वल टू -4 प्लस में 25 प्लस में 20 आयोटा। नाउ दिस इज नंबर -4 प्लस 25 व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 21 प्लस में 20 आयोटा व्हिच इज a प्लस आयोटा b फॉर्म। इट मींस रियल पार्ट, रियल पार्ट मींस a। व्हाट सर्कल पार्ट इज हियर 21 एंड व्हाट्स द इमेजिनरी पार्ट, इमेजिनरी पार्ट इज व्हाट 20। सॉरी आई एम राइट हियर एरर। This is the representations. Now we have to do same. In this, first we have to do multiplication. So do multiply. Now 3 × -2 we get -6. 3 × 3 we get 9 iota. -5 iota × -2 -10 plus 10 iota. -5 iota × 3 iota we get -15 iota square. Now solve this. -6. 9 plus 10 iota which is equal to 19 iota. And what's the values of iota scale again? -1. So this is -9, 6 plus 19 iota and this becomes plus 15. Plus 15 minus 6 we get 9 plus 19 iota, it means a plus iota b form. So our real part is 9 and our imaginary part is 9. This is the representation. Please make a note. Now I am going to solve next fourth part of the question number 2. Now solve this. It is basically simple. We have to express in terms of a plus iota b. We have to do its multiplication. So do multiply √6 × √6 we get 6. Now to multiply √6 into this we get 5√6 iota. Now to multiply this term with √6, what we will got? √6 iota divided by 5. Now do multiply this, what we will got? Iota 5 multiplied by iota 1/5. So what's the result? 6 plus 5√6 iota. This will remain same. 5 will cancel out with 5. But we will go iota into iota, iota square. So this 6 plus 5√6 iota minus √6 divided by 5 iota and iota square is equal to -1. Now what's the value? 6 minus 1 which is equal to 5 plus 5√6 iota minus √6 iota divided by 5. Take an LCM 5. But we will get 5 × 5 = 25 plus 25√6 iota minus √6 iota. So this will be 25 term as it is. 25 minus 1 because 25√6 minus 1√6 we get 24√6 iota divided by 5. Please make a note first. Please do a correction. What we do wrong here? The fourth term. If you multiply √5 iota 1/5 into iota 5, negative positive becomes negative. So we get here negative. We get negative. So it becomes positive 1. So 6 plus 1 here we get 7. And 7 into 5 will be got 35. So please do a correction here. This is a 35. Now you can write individually 35 divided by 5 plus 5 root 6. So this is the final answer. You can also cut in 5 7 35. So you will got 7 plus 24√6 divided by 5 iota. This is form of a plus iota B form. Now you have to do the same for the sixth part. In this you have to do first to multiply. Now do multiplication. 1 by 2 multiply by minus 2 by 3 plus 1 by 4 into iota multiply by minus 2 by 3 minus now 1 by 4 iota multiply by 1 by 2. 1 by 2 multiply 1 by 4 iota. Now plus minus minus 1 by 4 iota multiply by 1 by 4 iota. Now solve this. 2 is cancelled out with 2. What we will get? Minus 1 by 3. Solve this. 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are 4. We get minus iota divided by 2 into 3, 6. Now solve this. 1 into 1, 1. And iota comes as it is. 2 into 4, 8. Now solve this. Iota into iota, iota square. 4 into 4, 16. Now solve further. Minus 1 by 3, minus iota by 6, minus iota by 8. And iota square is negative 1, so this becomes positive 1, 1 by 16. Now take a LCM. What's the LCM of this? I think 48 to solve. 3 sixes in, we get minus 16. 6 8s are minus 8 iota, minus 6 iota, and plus 3. Now solve this further. Minus 16 plus 3. What we will put? Minus 13. And minus 8 and minus 6, minus 14 iota divided by 48. Now do separate. Minus 13 upon the 48. Minus 14 upon me 48 iota. You can also cut them. If we cut them, 2, 7, 24. What we will got? Minus 13 divided by 48, minus 7 by 24 iota. This is form of A plus iota B, where A is minus 13 by 48 and B is minus 7 by 24. Please make a note. Now please make a note. Question number 7 of the second question. It's very simple but requires some calculations. Do it yourself. Firstly, root 5 minus 7 iota. And this one is A minus B whole square. Apply A minus B whole square identity. A square plus B square minus 2 A, B, same here. If we change the order, what can I write as 7 iota minus 2 whole square? So it becomes same, A minus B whole square. Apply this. A square, 49 iota square plus B square minus 2 A into B. Now solve this. Root 5 minus 7 iota. This is 5 plus 49 iota square is minus 1, minus 2 into 7, 14 root 5 iota plus 49 iota square is again minus 1 plus 4 minus 2 into 2, 4 into 7, 28 iota. Now solve this. Root 5 minus 7 iota into 5 minus 49 minus 14 root 5 iota minus 49 plus 4 minus 28 iota. Again solve. Root 5 minus 7 iota. 5 minus 49, what we will got? Minus 44 minus 14 root 5 iota minus 49 plus 4 minus 45 minus 28 iota. Now to solve at yourself. If you solve further, do multiplication, you will get this answer. Please make sure yourself. Now our next question is question number 3rd, first part. Divide 2 minus 3 iota by 5 minus 4 iota. It's very simple. What we have to do? We have to do माइनस थ्री आयोटा डिवाइड बाई 5 माइनस 4 आयोटा. प्लीज कीप इट इन माइंड, यू गोट द आंसर इन टर्म्स ऑफ आयोटा प्रेजेंट मस्ट बी न्यूमरेटर. इफ यू गोट एन आंसर इन टर्म्स ऑफ आयोटा विच इज प्रेजेंट इन डिनोमिनेटर, देन यू हैव टू डू रेशनलाइजेशन एंड आफ्टर दैट यू हैव टू राइट द रिजल्ट. प्लीज कीप इट इन माइंड. बट इन दिस वी गोट iota in the denominator, so we have to eliminate this, and this can be done by using rationalization. So do rationalize. Two minus three iota, five minus four iota. We have to change the sign and multiply and divide. So five plus four iota we have to do multiply. As well as 5 plus 4 iota we have to do divide. Now numerator is multiplied with numerator and denominator is denominator. Look at this, this is a minus b and this is a plus b. So every time whenever you do rationalization you will got a minus b and a plus b. So the answer is a square minus b square. I am applying this concept. Firstly we have to do multiply. 5 into 2 10, 5 into 3 15 iota, 4 iota into 2, 8 iota, and 4 iota into 3 iota, minus 8, 12 iota into iota square. This is become 5 square and this is becomes 4 iota whole square. I am using a minus b into a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. Now solve this. 10 minus 15 plus 8, we get minus 7 iota. Minus 12. And what's the value of iota square is? Negative 1. 5 square is 25. 4 square is 60. And iota square. You got 10 minus 7 iota. Negative negative becomes positive 12. Divide by 25. Minus 16. And iota square is negative 1. So you will got 10 plus 12, which is 22 minus 7 iota. This is 25. Negative negative becomes positive. So you got 22 minus 7 iota divided by 25 or 16, 41. So you got answer 22 divided by 41 minus 7 upon by 41 iota. This is the final answer. You have to put the answer in terms of a plus iota b always. So please keep up. Now, so this is our question number 3, part 2nd. Find a complex number. It means we have to do find out complex number. Let x plus iota y is a complex number. This one is a complex number. Now, which when multiplied by, it means we have to do multiply. X plus iota y we have to do multiply with 2 plus 5 iota. Gives, it means which is equal to 3 minus 7 iota. I hope you understand. What it said, a complex number is multiplied by this number gives this number. It means we have to solve and find out the values of x and y. So it's very simple. If we take it on to the right hand side and calculate as usually, what's the result? X plus iota y is equal to 3 minus 7 iota divided by 2 plus 5 iota. Now again, denominator contain iota terms, so we have to do rationalization. I'm doing rationalization. 3 minus 7 iota, 2 plus 5 iota. Multiply by changing the sign. Here sign is positive, so we have to take sign negative. 2 minus 5 iota. Now it's very simple to multiply this. 3 into 2, 6. 3 into minus 5, minus 15 iota. Minus 7 into 2, minus 14 iota. Minus 7 into minus 5, plus 35 iota into iota, iota square. Now here again a plus b, a minus b. So a square minus b square. Now solve this. 6, 15 minus 14. We get 29 minus iota, and iota square is again negative 1. 2 square is 4. 5 square is 25 into iota square. Now 6 minus 29 iota and plus minus 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 35 divided by 4 minus 25 iota square is again negative 1. So what's our result? 6 minus 35, we get minus 29. Minus 29 iota divided by 4 negative negative plus 25, which will be equal to minus 29 minus 29 iota divided by 29. So if we solve them, 29 by 29 sine negative minus 29 by 29 iota, we got minus 1 minus iota. This is our final answer. Now solve this question number 4. Express in a plus iota b form. It means the question is similar, so we are doing another example. So please make a look. In this term, the first term is negative. It's very, it becomes very simple if you change the order. What's the order? 5 plus 2 iota. It can be written as root 3 iota minus 1. Because if we change root 3 iota as a first and minus 1 as a second term. Now, what we have to do? Through rationalization. So, multiply root 3 iota plus 1. Into root 3 iota plus 1. Change the sign and do multiply and divide. Now solve this. 5 into root 3. 5 root 3 iota. 5 into 1. 5. 2 into root 3. 2 root 3 iota. 2 iota into 1. 2 iota. Get the same. A minus B. A plus B. A square minus B square. Now solve this. 5 root 3, 5 root 3 iota, 2 root 3 iota, 5 into 7 root 3 iota, plus 5 as it is, and this one is 2 iota, please make a note here, we do wrong, 5 into root 3, 5 root 3 iota, 5 into 1, 5. 2 iota into root 3, 2 root 3 iota in square. This is iota square. Now solve this. 5 root 3 iota plus 5. Now this is iota square is negative. 2 root 3 iota square becomes negative plus 2 iota. Root 3, 3 iota square minus 1 square is 1. Now solve this further. What's the result? 5 root 3 iota plus 5 minus 2 root 3 plus 2 iota. And here iota square becomes negative 1 minus 1. So what we will, we have to combine it in the form of a plus iota b. Here the real part is 5 and minus 2 root 3. 5 minus 2 root 3, this is the real part. In this we have taken common iota. What we will got? Iota. Here we got 5 root 3 and here we got 2. Divide by this one is minus 3 and this one is minus 1. So we got 5 minus 2 root 3. This one is minus 3 and minus 1, which is equal to minus 4 plus iota. 5 root 3 plus 2 minus 3 and minus 1 minus 4. So you can also write as, if you change the sign, either you can write it as, or you can also solve it 5 minus 2 root 3. If we change the sign, negative if we take common, so negative negative becomes positive, sign of the system becomes negative, this becomes positive. And this becomes whole 5 root 3 plus 2 divided by 4. I write sign negative to the upper parts. Please make a note first and check the corrections. So our answer is correct. Please make a note. So this is our second part of the question number 2. Now do the same step. First we have to remove the sign. How we remove the signs? 3 plus minus 1 means iota square. Again here माइनस वन स्क्वेयर रूट मीन्स आयोटा, और यू कैन डायरेक्टली रिटन एज माइनस वन स्क्वेयर रूट इज इक्वल टू आयोटा. आई एम सॉल्विंग दिस हियर, 3 प्लस आयोटा स्क्वेयर बिकम्स आयोटा इफ वी टेक आउट फ्रॉम द स्क्वेयर रूट. सेम हियर, 2 माइनस आयोटा. इन दिस टर्म अगेन वी गॉट अ आयोटा टर्म्स इन द डिनोमिनेटर, सो वी हैव टू डू रैशनलाइजेशन. प्लीज डू मल्टीप्लाई, 3 प्लस आयोटा, 2 माइनस आयोटा, डू रैशनलाइज. टू प्लस आयोटा डिवाइड बाई 2 प्लस आयोटा. नाउ सॉल्व दिस, फर्स्ट वी विल गो 2 मल्टीप्लाई 3 इंटू 2 6, 3 इंटू आयोटा 3 आयोटा, आयोटा इंटू 2 2 आयोटा, आयोटा इंटू आयोटा आयोटा स्क्वायर. हियर सेम ए माइनस बी एंड ए प्लस बी, व्हाट्स द रिजल्ट? ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर, दिस इज 2 स्क्वायर माइनस आयोटा स्क्वायर. 6 3 प्लस 2 आयोटा विच इज इक्वल टू 5 आयोटा, आयोटा स्क्वायर इज अगेन नेगेटिव 1, 2 स्क्वायर इज 4, आयोटा स्क्वायर इज नेगेटिव 1, इट बिकम्स 6 माइनस 1 5 प्लस 5 आयोटा डिवाइड बाई 4 माइनस माइनस प्लस 1 प्लस, विच इज इक्वल टू 5 प्लस 5 आयोटा डिवाइड बाई 5. सो राइट सेपरेटली 5 डिवाइड बाई 5 प्लस में 5 डिवाइड बाई 5 आयोटा, बट वी द फाइनल रिजल्ट 5 बाई 5 1, 5 बाई 5 1 आयोटा. दिस इज द फाइनल आंसर. प्लीज मेक अ नेक्स्ट पार्ट, 1 प्लस आयोटा होल पावर 4 एंड 1 माइनस आयोटा होल पावर 4. अगेन द पावर 4 इज सेम फॉर बोथ न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर, सो मेक इट अ सिंगल टर्म एंड टेक अ होल पावर रेज टू द 4. So we can write as 1 plus iota divided by 1 minus iota whole power 4. Now again the term complex in iota terms, so we have to do rationalization. Now do rationalization, 1 plus iota divided by 1 minus iota, change the sign, 1 plus iota, 1 plus iota. Now do multiply, 1 into 1, 1. 1 into iota, iota, iota into 1, iota, iota into iota, iota square. Here the same, a minus b, a plus b, 1 square minus iota square. Solve this, 1 plus iota, iota, 2 iota, iota square is minus 1, divided by 1 square is 1, iota square is negative 1. And whole power 4 remains the same. Now solve this, 1 cancel out with 1, 2 iota, so negative negative becomes 1 plus 1, 2, whole power 4. Again 2 cancel out with 2, but we will put iota whole power 4, and what's the values of iota 4 is 1. So this is our final answer. Please take our next question, 3 plus 4 iota raised to the power negative 1, so we have to remove the power negative by taking into the denominator parts. So we can write as 3 plus 4 iota. Again the term of imaginary terms in the denominator, we have to do rationalization. 3 minus 4 iota, 3 minus 4 iota. Now to multiply, if we do multiply 1, we get 3 minus 4 iota, a plus b, a minus b. Apply a square minus b square. Now solve this, 3 minus 4 iota, 3 square is 9 and 4 square is 16 and iota square is term as it is. 3 minus 4 iota, 9 minus 16, iota square becomes negative 1. 3 minus 4 iota, 9 minus minus plus, we got 3 minus 4 iota divided by 25. So please write it in the separate term, 3 by 25 minus 4 by 25 iota. This one is your final answer. Please make a note first. So this is your question number 9th part from the question number 4th, and this is your question number 10. All the questions are similar, but we have to keep in mind you have to solve as you are usually solve. Please make a note. And what we have to do in this? Firstly, we have to take it LCM, then we have to do multiply, and then you get a term of imaginary in the denominator, you get rationalize and take the final answer. Same you have to do here. Firstly, the numerator is solved, denominator is solved, then you will got a term of denominator imaginary. So you have to do rationalization. After that, you will get the final answer. So you can do it yourself. So please make a look. I am also trying to do these questions. Firstly, what we have to do? We have to take its LCM. Now solve this. What's the LCM is? 1 minus 2 iota into 1 plus iota. Now solve this. 1 plus iota plus 3 into 1, 3 minus 3 into 2, 6 iota. Now solve this. 3 plus 4 iota is this. 2 minus 4 iota is this. 1 plus 3, we get 4 iota minus 6 iota, we get minus 5 iota. Now to say multiply, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2 iota, 2 iota, iota into 1, iota, iota into minus 2, minus 2 iota square. 3 plus 4 iota divided by 2 minus 4 iota. Now further solve, 4 minus 5 iota divided by 1 minus 2 iota and plus iota, we get minus iota, minus 2, and iota square is negative 1. So I am writing this same 3 plus 4 iota, 2 minus 4 iota. Now solve this. 4 minus 5 iota is 1 minus iota, minus minus plus, we get plus 2. 3 plus 4 iota and 2 minus 4 iota. Same we have to do here. 4 minus 5 iota, 1 plus 2, 3 minus iota. This is 3 plus 4 iota and 2 minus 4 iota. Now we have to do a multiplication numerator as well as denominator. What's the result? 4 into 3, 12, 3 into 5, 15 iota, 4 into 4, 16 iota, 4 into 5, 20 iota square. Same here, 2 into 3, 6, 2 into iota, 2 iota, minus 4 iota into 3, minus 12 iota, minus 4 iota into iota, plus 4 iota square. What's the final result? 12 minus 15 plus 16, which is equal to plus iota, minus 20. Iota square is negative 1. 6 minus 2 and minus 4, 12 minus 14 iota plus 4, iota square is negative 1. What's the result? 12 plus iota minus 20 plus becomes plus 20. 6 minus 14 iota and 4 minus 2 minus 1 minus 4. We got 20 plus 12, 32 plus iota divided by 6 minus 4, 2 minus 14 iota. Now you get in the denominator part imaginary term. So you have to do rationalization. If you do rationalization, 32 plus iota, 2 minus 14 iota, 2 rationalization, 2 plus 14 iota, 2 plus 14 iota. Now you have to do multiply and solve this result. So after solving, doing rationalization and multiplication, you get this answer. Please make a note. Then I am going to take our next part, 10th part. You have to do the same step. First you have to do multiply and then you have to do rationalization. So I think you can do it yourself. So please make all as a note. So if you multiply these two numbers, you get this number. If we do multiply, we get this number. Now after solving, we get this number, and 12 plus 5 iota upon 4 plus 3 iota. Now we do rationalization. 4 plus 3 iota, minus 3 iota, 4 minus 3 iota, and solve this and you get this final answer. So we have complete our question number 5. So please make a note. So we did our question number 1 to question number 5 and almost we did all its different parts. I hope you like my video. If you really like my video, so please do subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes, and also press a button of like and share it to your friends also. We take each and every questions of the Elvic Mathematics, and if you are reading from the NCRT, then you will find all the questions NCRT as well as Elvic Mathematics in my channel. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. This is our first part of the exercise 5.2. Then I will prepare our next part for the exercise 5.2. So just you have to wait for the next video. Thanks for watching my video from start to end. Again repeat, don't forget to subscribe my channel.